instructions like that aren't ideal, obviously, but you know, it's not a place for me to comment on things that they come. I mean, I have other things that I want to ask them, and I'm sure you have your opinions on it, so it's not really my place to say. I mean, these are distractions, simple as. And I'm sure that, as I said, I'm sure they're very difficult decisions for Ricky and the management to make, but I'm sure they've got the reasons to do that. And, you know, I mean, it's completely out of our hands, and you're going to have to ask them. You know, our first performance was a solid performance, we all realise that, and last night, I think, really give everybody a realisation that, you know, we did pretty well. I think having a performance like that just bring out a lot of confidence. I think, you know, there was really not many areas where you could bring out any negatives in that. And the field and the energy that the boys are producing in the field is superb, I think. We have a control of the pace of the game, and the skills that we're using is very good. But you know, we're not going to get carried away by everything, and know that we're going to still have to play to our absolute potential to you know, get the semis. But there's a lot of confidence around at the moment, and it's you know, it's all good. It's a really good feel good factor. The Netherlands is in the forefront of our minds at the moment, so we're really, as a team, looking to see what their strengths and weaknesses are. Obviously, we've got computers and stuff, but I think it's going to be a lot. I think there's a lot of teams that are going to push each other. I think there's going to be a lot of teams that beat each other. I think there's going to be one specific team that's going to unite everywhere. I think 2020 cricket does bring the teams closer together. You see the Bangladeshes who may surprise a few. I think that's why it's going to be an exciting tournament. We're going to have to play to our absolute best if we're going to go and win it. So at the moment, I'm quite happy with the position we're in. And I don't want to come out with any big statements other than the fact that we can win it. We believe, as a team, that we could win it. It's a great opportunity for us. Now, 2020 cricket, as I said, brings teams closer together. And, you know, it's, anything can happen, I guess, on the day. And if you see performances like Ravi Papar and Luke Wright last night, you're going to win games. And when you play against the better sides, I think sometimes when you see the more experienced guys who played a lot of 2020 cricket, sometimes you see there is a bit of a gap in terms of some players, if you know what I mean. But we're developing some cricketers on that side now that have got a lot of power, I think. And that's the great thing, is that, you know, Luke Wright hasn't been exposed to a lot of IPLs and like that, but he's still produced the game, coming through the county scene with a lot of power, and he's obviously, his bowling's very, very handy as well. So he's an all-round package. Yeah, I think, again, we're going to have to look at the sides that we're playing against and really adapt to the kind of the personnel that they've got in the sides. You know, there may be some occasions where we can get two spinners in the side. But again, you've got to play to your strengths. You know, we've got different strengths than what other teams have got, and I think, you know, the way the three seamers have bowled, three heavy seamers have bowled, is exceptional. They've produced some great skills, they've come up with some different ideas, and, you know, it's great to see, because they're making it really hard for the batsmen to score, and obviously they're taking it. So I do want to blow my own trumpet. I mentioned it to them about 5 weeks ago, if you could start practicing that. I'll give them a quick text when I got back from the IPL. It wasn't because I'd seen people doing it right on round doing it, it was because I was trying to figure out why all these left-handers have been so successful over there. And with my thinking cap on, as I usually do, sometimes overthink, I thought, why not produce an even bigger angle and surely it'll be even harder. And as a batsman, you know, if you take one shot off and doing that sweep shot, it's really getting the players to hit in one area. These are just, you know, plan B's and plan C's. And you've got to make sure, because you know the Yorkers over the wicket can go in this format of the game. You know, people are sweeping a lot better now, even reverse sweeping. So manipulating the field like that is, it's very hard for captains to kind of stop the flow of runs. So it's just another plan. I mean, as I said, I may use it all the time, I may not. So I think all the players have got a lot more belief in themselves. and the players were, because of the experience that they've had, and not just 2020 cricket, I'm seeing them in the way that they've played in one day cricket and gain that experience and gain that confidence, it makes us a lot stronger side. And the very key positions as well, that the likes of Ravi, obviously, KP and the Brodies, and Jimmy, the way that they've progressed over the past 2 or 3 years has been exceptional. I mean, the skill level now is right up there with the best leagues in the world. It's very, very fast, even just the Scotland game the other night, you know, actually blew us away a little bit. It really is a fast game. I don't remember it being that fast as captain, but it can really get away from you. And that's why you've got to get a good start. But hopefully now that, you know, you learn a lot from your mistakes. I've always said that to you, whether it be from a personal point of view, scoring managers, you learn a lot from your mistakes. And I made mistakes last year being captain. You know, I'm the first person to hold my hands up and say that. But you learn more from them than the other way around. And hopefully this time around, I'm certainly enjoying it. I'm loving taking the boys out there. I'm enjoying the camaraderie that we've got and the belief that we've got. And hopefully I'm a little bit kind of more relaxed about it as well. I'm enjoying it, and hopefully we can go far in the tournament. He's quick, very quick, and again, he's obviously he's a left arm, so he's got that angle going across the right-handers. And yeah, he's a wicket taker. I think that's the key thing about them guys, is he goes mid-140s, can get up to 150. He hits the bat really hard. So that's certainly one area that we're going to have to be very careful of come tomorrow night. But he's certainly he's a good depth bowler as well. He's going to be a threat for them. I always think your wicketkeeper is kind of the energy provider. And, you know, Fozzy, he hasn't had a bat yet, which has been a little bit of a shame. But I think Fozzy, the way his glove work behind the stumps, and his energy that he gives to the size and the gesture, has been superb. I think I've wanted him to do.